So yeah, this one's been rattling around in my head for a while now. You ever feel like you're building on a moving sidewalk, but suddenly someone hits the turbo button? That's honestly how this whole new era of Apple development feels right now. I was reading this article, The Great Shift in Apple Development from Captain Swift UI, and no joke, it was like reading the inside of my own brain. You know when you've been thinking something, but then someone else just puts it way better than you ever could. That was this. There's just this sense that one era is ending and a totally new one is kicking off. And honestly, if you're building solo, trying to keep up, this shift is loud. Just real quick, I'm Daniel. Been living in the iOS trenches for, what, 8 years now? Started off freelancing, working with clients, figuring out what actually works and what just burns you out. But after WW25, I kind of flipped the switch and went all in on solo dev life. Since then, I've shipped a bunch of my own apps, started putting everything out there in public, and honestly, these days, pretty much all my energy is going into Crafters Lab. This isn't just another tutorial site or another AI clone farm. This is my actual home base for solo devs who treat AI like a real teammate, not just a vending machine. It's packed with solo devs' resources and access to my live command center. This is where I actually plan out new apps, draft the docs, write my .md files, and share the real process behind every build. There's a full curated Swift and Swift UI library in there too. Basically, all the deep dive resources I actually use to fine-tune, train, and power up Claude or Codex. And the newest piece, Ops Lab, is where I'm building and sharing all my AI agent systems, those Notion setups, workflows, and automations that keep the whole indie stack connected. So, yeah, if you want your own command center and not have to start from scratch, and honestly, if you want to get in early and lock your membership, now is kind of the sweet spot. And yeah, if you're part of the Patreon crew, huge thanks. And heads up, everything's moving over to crafterslab.dev. So first up, let's talk about this idea of eras. Captain Swift UI nails it. For the last decade, we've basically been living in the same design and development universe. From iOS 7's flat revolution all the way up to iOS 18, we all got real comfortable with size classes, regular versus compact, making stuff work for iPhones and iPads, maybe throwing in a split view for the iPad if we were feeling spicy. There was a playbook, you know? But now, Apple just set that playbook on fire. Liquid glass isn't just a new look, it's a design system with its own vision and direction. It's not just about layering on some blur or gradient, it's about rethinking how apps fit across a bunch of new devices. I mean, we're talking windowing on iPad, foldables coming soon, who knows what glasses on the horizon. Everything's just so much more fluid, more unpredictable. And if you're a solo dev, that hits hard. The stuff we use to just assume about layout, about navigation, about user flow, it's suddenly all up for grabs. There's real excitement here. Don't get me wrong, the demos look stunning. But there's also that deep, low-key anxiety of, oh crap, do I need to relearn everything again? I've felt that. It's not just a facelift, it's a full reset on how apps are meant to feel. And if you're shipping, you have to stay nimble. But the good news? These moments are where solo devs usually shine. We're scrappy, we pivot fast, and we can afford to experiment way more than a big company with 10 PMs breathing down their neck. So yeah, it's a wild new era, but it's also a massive playground if you're willing to keep learning. All right, here's the section where the ground really starts to move under our feet. Swift 6 is here, and with it, strict concurrency is basically table stakes. There's no more getting by without understanding actors, sendable types, main actor by default. Even if you're not using them every day, you need to know why you'd use them, where data races can creep in, and how to ship safe code that doesn't blow up the minute a user multitasks. It's not just a fancy interview question anymore. It's required knowledge, like Captain Swift UI says. And honestly, thank goodness, data races are the kind of bug that make you question your life choices, and Apple's finally making safe code the default, not the exception. But that's not even the wildest shift. We're also staring down the app-less future. This is the part that feels like science fiction until you actually build for it. Widgets, snippets, intents, live activities. More and more, your app isn't even an app anymore. Users just want a glance, a shortcut, a tap on their always-on display. I feel this all the time. Sometimes I'm working on a feature and realize, wait, nobody's going to open the app for this. They're going to want a widget or a shortcut or some kind of quick result, and then they're gone. And honestly, that means the whole structure of how we plan and build apps has to shift too. Oh, and then there's the AI piece, Apple Foundation models right on device. Captain Swift UI points out these aren't ChatGPT level giants, not yet, but they're fast, private, and crucially local. For me as a solo dev, that's huge. No more worrying about internet lag, cloud costs, or user privacy drama. You can build genuinely smart features like natural language summaries, on-device recommendations, all without the risk of leaking data. Is it as powerful as a big server model? No, but is it good enough for most app use cases and way more trustworthy? Absolutely. And it just feels more Apple. But, and this is real, the majority of resources, books, and even the big How to Swift UI courses, they're already out of date. Captain Swift UI says it straight up. The Swift cookbook he published last year, already showing its age. So if you're starting a new project, you're back in explorer mode, figuring out the new rules as you go. That's scary and exciting and very, very real for indie devs who have to learn while shipping. So here's the question. With everything changing, layouts, concurrency, AI, even what an app means, how do you, as a solo dev, not get crushed under the weight of it all? Honestly, here's what's saving me right now. First, you've got to stay curious and let go of the right way mentality. The new era isn't about memorizing patterns. It's about picking up principles. Learn how concurrency works, not just the syntax. Dive into liquid glass, not just to copy Apple's samples, but to see how you can adapt your flows and UI for whatever wild device ships next. And with foundation models, don't be afraid to start small. Sprinkle in natural language features where they make sense, get a feel for what's possible, and build from there. Second, build your own playbook. Like, actually write stuff down. I keep a livingrules.md for every app, not just to remind myself, but so I can onboard AI tools like Claude, Cursor, and Codex faster. Every weird build trick, every, oh, don't forget this gotcha, it goes in the doc. That way, next time I'm thrown into a Swift 6 Plus project with a new windowing mode or some AI workflow, I'm not starting from scratch. And yeah, it means my AI agents are actually helpful instead of just guessing what I want. And finally, lean into the community. If there was ever a time to ask for help, swap code snippets, or just share, does this feel wild to you too? Stories, it's now, I promise. You're not the only one relearning how Apple wants us to build apps every 6 months. So yeah, if you're still hanging out here at the end, honestly, you're kind of a legend. I really appreciate you sticking around. It means a lot, for real. If anything I said tonight actually clicked or just made you feel a little less lost in all this chaos, do yourself a favor. Check out crafterslab.dev. That's honestly where I'm dropping everything I wish I'd had when I started out. The real stuff, not the corporate fluff. And you know, it's not just some resource dump. We've got a Discord where people are actually trying to keep each other accountable, cut through the fog, and just talk shop about solo dev life, the wins, the failures, all of it. Plus, there's a whole pile of resources coming. App blueprints, Figma foundations, actual growth insights, the stuff you'd pay way too much for anywhere else. But what I'm really pumped about is the Notion workspace. There's dedicated team spaces in there. Like, you've got the playbook, which is honestly just my live command center. That's where I plan apps, draft docs, share the raw, unfiltered process behind every build. Then there's Swift Brain, which is basically my personal curated Swift and Swift UI library. I'm talking the real deep dive stuff I use to fine tune and train AI tools like Claude, Cursor, and Codex. And yeah, the newest one, Ops Lab, that's where all the AI agent setups live, the Notion workflows, automations, all the glue that keeps my stack connected. Together, it's what I'm calling Crafter OS, this weird evolving operating system for solo devs who actually want to treat AI like a teammate, not just a magic vending machine. And yeah, I'm still refining it, still breaking it, still figuring out what actually works. But honestly, that's the whole point. If you want to get in as an early member and lock in your price, I mean, now's probably the best time. Not gonna lie, it's kind of wild seeing how fast this is all moving. Anyway, look, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for listening. And if you're building solo too, just know you're not actually alone, even when it feels like it. Keep shipping, keep tinkering. And you know what? I'll see you over at crafterslab.dev or maybe in the comments. Either way, keep crafting. Peace.